So hello everyone, my name is Khemendra and I am welcoming you in your channel Creatrix. So first of all, I would like to welcome you, all of you, and I want to suggest that you should share this video with your friends so that the other student can also be beneficial with the kind of knowledge which we are dealing here. Okay, so today again, this is the 9th lecture for me, and this lecture will bring another very important aspect for you today, that what should be the preparation of GATE like examination, engineering services like examination. And in this complete question series, I am providing you the questions which have been already came in the examination or which are very, very important. Okay, so first of all, I would like to tell you, each one of you, to please share this video. Share this video with your friends. Like this video and subscribe the channel if you are new to this. And one another announcement for those students who are part of this video, that I am right now running a question series on SSC JEE and the PSU examination. JEE and PSU, and you can find it on the special classes, on my special classes on Unacademy app. On Unacademy app, special classes, you can find me. Here you can find me, and this is a very important set of classes of 19 classes. And in each time, I will be providing the runtime, a rapid fire question series I will be providing to you. And this question series are very, very helpful for your examination purpose. Okay. So at 5 p.m., I will be starting another session. That will be my 11th session. So I really hope you guys will like and will definitely going to come and at that session also. Okay. So these are all things. So first of all, I will just tell you about the members of my team. Ankit sir, you very well know Ankit sir. Vishal sir, Shankar sir, Rahul sir, Kamesh sir, Pramit sir, Ajay sir, myself, Khemendra, Sharma sir and Rajkumar sir. I am Khemendra. I am M.Tech from MNIT Jaipur. I have around 2 years of experience in teaching in GATE and ESE domain. And I'll teach these three subjects in GATE and ESE domain. And I have around 1 year of experience in doing the government job also. So if you wanted to join the Unacademy Plus subscription, you can join it by the KHEMLIVE is my code. With this code, you will get the 10% discount in each and every subscription of Unacademy Plus. Okay, guys. So whether you want to support me, you want that I'm working good and you wanted to support me, you can take the subscription with this my code. Okay, so what does it mean, okay, that if you are taking the subscription from my code, you are entitled to see only my classes? No, it doesn't mean this thing. You have the authority to see the classes of each and every member of our team in the GATE ESE domain. And apart from our team, there are lots and lots of teams which are working for Unacademy platform, and they are providing the non-technical portion, the technical portion, all the portions for different kind of examination they are providing. So this thing is very, very useful for you. After this, what is the usefulness of this? It has daily live classes, as you very well know that this class is also a recorded one. So, but in the Unacademy subscription, you will get a daily live classes, and the class which I am going to take at 5 p.m. It is also a live class. Okay. So RIB is there, rank improvement batch. I am running a crash course right now, in which I am dealing the synchronous machine right now. And I will be ending the machines part. If you want to prepare for AJEE examination, this will be your one-stop solution, because I have although covered lots and lots of subject in Unacademy Plus. So all the recorded video that you can see, and in the next month also, I am planning to bring lot of things for the AJEE examination. Okay, AJEE examination for UPPCL examination. If you see my way of teaching, you'll find that I'll not run for the knowledge. I'll just run for what things that students should understand maximum bit of it. Okay, so this is my objective for teaching. In both language, English and Hindi language, you'll get the classes, weekly test, doubt clearing session will happen after every three classes. This is what I was telling, that there are lots and lots of educators which are teaching there in the Unacademy Plus. So these are the one of the finest batches you can find in Unacademy Plus. This is from our team. So this is the complete interface with in which how we are teaching you in Unacademy Plus platform. And this is quite impressive slides. Okay. So with this, you can have an idea that how you are going to learn in the Unacademy Plus thing. So these are the doubt clearing. This is the doubt clearing session. And in the runtime, that educator is solving the doubt of a student, which he has posted here. This one is the poll of leaderboard, overall poll of leaderboard, like what class I will be starting at 5 p.m. There will be around 30 to 35 questions, and after 30 to 35 questions, after every 10 questions, I'll show students this kind of poll that they are in at which position. Okay, so this is also a very awesome thing about the Unacademy Plus thing. If you wanted to know the more about this Unacademy Plus thing, you can just see my special class. Okay, you just see my special class and see how students are learning there. Okay, so you'll find much more better thing in there. Okay, so this is all about this thing, and now I am moving forward for my question. The first question for me will be this. This is my first question, guys. So I just wanted to you all pay attention and please see this question. What the question is saying, the Y input of CRO, a signal is defined by, okay, the Y input is given by 10 sine 100 T. This is like 10 sine omega T. And the X input, 10 cos 100 T. So this is, one is sine term and one is cos term. The magnitude is same. Magnitude is same. This is the magnitude A1 and A2 I am writing here. One is in the sine term and one is in the cos term. What I can interpret it with this thing, that there is a phase difference of. Phase difference of what? Pi by 2. If there is a phase difference of pi by 2, what will be the Lissajous pattern? Okay. What is this Y and X? These Y and X are the deflecting plate. This, because these two signals are provided. If my sine wave, yeah, for, my sinusoidal waves are provided in a deflecting plate, so a vertical deflecting plate and the horizontal deflecting plate. This thing I have already told, and I have already showed in my last session, last question. And that's why I have bring this question in the first place. That in the previous section, I have just shown the straight lines, the what should be the value for the straight line. For the straight line, the phase difference should be 0 and 180. For the straight lines, the this phase difference should be 0 and 180. But for this pi by 2 phase difference, how my graph should be look like? We are going to see in few minutes. Suppose this is now my x-axis and y-axis. Now, there will be a circle. This is my circle. And now what will be the direction? What will be the direction of this? This will be the direction here. This is a clockwise direction. This is my clockwise direction. This is my X terminal. This is my Y. Now after understanding this thing, what should be the area of this, what should be the equation of this complete circle that will be equal to x square plus y square will be equal to a square, because a will be equal to a1. In both the cases, magnitude is same, as magnitude is same. As magnitude is same. Now, this is for phase different. Phi will be equal to pi by 2. It means 90 degree. When it is a clockwise, what will happen when it is an anti-clockwise direction? In the anti-clockwise direction, the screen will show circle only. In the anti-clockwise direction, suppose it is moving in the anti-clockwise direction. This is the case when phase difference is your 270 degree. So keep this point a note point. After 180 degree, the direction, if before the 180 degree, the direction is in clockwise direction of the arrow, and after 180 degree, my direction will be my anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so this is the thing you should remember, and you should note down all these things, because these kind of things will be asking in the examination above and after. Okay, so I will just explain one more thing about it right now. I'll just explain one more thing what I will be explaining. This is my case number 2. My case number 2 says that my value of phi phase difference will be between 0 to 90. If my value of phase difference is between 0 to 90, then what will happen? My x, this is my x. Now, if it is between 0 to 90, then this type of graph will be observed in the CRO screen. If the phase difference is between 0 to 90, this is my 45, and this is blue line graph will be observed in the CRO screen. Blue line graph will be observed in the CRO screen with this arrow direction. What is this? This is a structure. It is an ellipse structure. Okay, it is an ellipse structure where the value of phi will be between 0 to 90. Now what will happen? Again, another structure which I will be dealing, that will give you the value of phi is between 90 to 180 degree. Value of phi is between 90 to 180 degree. I will be dealing this thing also. So I will be covering all the CRO diagram for you. In such a way, so the direction of rotation will be clockwise direction. So one point I will tell you from 0 to 180, it is a clockwise direction. And from 180 to 360, it will give you the anti-clockwise clockwise direction. Now, in the same case, from, I'm just writing it in the different color so that you can, in the same case, the direction will be for the value of 180 angle phi angle 270. For this angle, in the same plot, it will show the anti-clockwise direction like this. And in the same plot, for this angle, for this direction, the angle will be 270, phi, 360. So with all these structures, you know that for what angle, what should be my this screen, what should be my screen shows. Okay, screen of CRO will going to show you. So please tell me, are you following all these approaches which I am telling you here? And you are understanding all these things, please tell me. After this, I will be moving ahead. And this question will become very, very easier for you now. Achha, when will it become straight line? It becomes straight line for two cases. For 0 degree and 180 degree. For 0 degree and 180 degree, it becomes straight line. For 90 and 270, it becomes circle. Rest of the things, it becomes ellipse. Okay. And ellipse in which direction, which current flows, that it is showing here. Okay. So I think you clearly know all the things now. All the things you know now very well. Now I am moving ahead for my next question. This is my next question for you. And please pay attention in this question, what it is trying to convey. So the question is saying the Lesage's pattern. Please read the question first of all. The question is saying the Lesage's pattern on the CRO is shown in the figure. Okay, this is my Lesage's pattern. Okay, so you need to calculate the frequency points. The frequency for the frequency point, I have already multiple times I have told you already that how to calculate this frequency points. You just need to find a few things, and after this your whole calculation will be very, very easier. Fx divided by Fy will be equal to points of tangents on vertical plane. Divided by points of tangent on horizontal plane. Okay. Now pay attention here. And very easily you are going to understand this thing. First of all, please, I will write what ratio we will be needing. Frequency of ratio on vertical plane to the horizontal plane. So, frequency of ratio of vertical plane will be Fy. Horizontal plane will be Fx. So, for the vertical plane, this is inverse related. It is inverse related. Dekho. Vertical is Fy and horizontal is Fx. Okay, so first thing I'm finding the value for vertical plane. For vertical plane I'm finding, then please pay attention and see what will be the answer. So please tell me how many number of intersection it had made with my vertical line. Vertical line made one intersection here and one intersection here. these are the maximum number of intersection which can be made here. Like here I am, this is my first intersection and this is my second intersection. These are the two intersection which my line has made firstly. So definitely vertical line, for my vertical line that must be connected in this way. So this will be divided by 2. So there are two number of intersection which it had made, my vertical line had made with this plot, with this flow. Now what about the second one? The second one says this is my horizontal line. Now please pay attention. Now I wanted to count you from 1 to 10 at how many number of cuts it is making to this horizontal line. This is my first cut. This is second. This is third. This is fourth. This is fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth. Eighth, ninth, tenth. The all three ten are my cuts on my horizontal axis, and this will be putting directly to this place. If it is putting directly to this place, what it becomes? It becomes 5 divided by 1, and 5 ratio 1 is my answer for this question. 5 ratio 1 becomes the answer of this question. Please tell me, have you followed it? It is a very easier thing. It is a very easier thing. I really hope you have followed it now, because you just needed to find out the intersection. You just needed to find out the intersections. Clear? With this, I am moving ahead further for my next question. Next question will be very, very easier one. So don't worry about much. So this is my next question for you. A 10 volt full, I'm just going to read the complete question for you. Yes. A 10 volt full scale voltmeter having, this is my sensitivity, is used to measure the output of a photovoltaic cell having an internal resistance. This is the internal resistance of photovoltaic cell. The voltmeter reads 5 volts. Voltmeter reads 5 volts. The voltage generated by the photovoltaic cell will be. This is simply what is the question is saying. This is simply the extension of voltage example with the series resistor. With the series resistor, this is what it is trying to convey. Now, first of all, you need to calculate the value of Vm. Now, first of all, you need to calculate the value of Rm, the meter resistance. Meter resistance will be sensitivity multiplication with the voltage. What will be the sensitivity? 100 kilo ohm per volt multiplication with the 10 volt. So the value of Rm will become 1 mega ohm. 1 mega ohm will be the value of Rm. So you know the value of Rm, and you know the value of Rs will be also 1 mega ohm. Just put these values in this formula, that Rs will be equal to m minus 1 times of Rm. So this is 1 will be equal to m minus 1 times of 1. So the value of m will become 2. This is what my multiplying factor. This is my multiplying factor for you guys. What is my multiplying factor? M will be equal to V divided by Vm. Vm is given here. This is my voltmeter reading, Vm. So you can easily calculate what will be the voltage generated at the photovoltaic. This is this point. This V will be my voltage generated by the cell. Okay. After this, simply this V will be 5 multiplication with 2. V will become 10 volt. Clearly, 10 volt will be my correct answer for you guys. This is the very easier one. Very easily, you are able to do such kind of questions. Okay. I hope this complete session is beneficial for you somehow. And you will be learning much more things from this course. Okay. So, the next question I'll just about to bring you. This is a very nice question asked in the 2 marks for the GATE examination. Just pay attention. Okay. What the question is saying, if 4 1 by 2 digit DMM has an error specification of 0.2% of reading of 10% plus 10 count, okay, if the DC voltage of 100 volt is read on its 200 volt full scale, a DC voltage of 100 volt is read on the 200 full scale value, the maximum error that can be expected in the reading. The maximum error that can be expected in the reading will be, first of all, I will be discussing all these points in details. Don't worry about it. In detail, I will just draw your attention. So first of all, I would like to write that what will be my maximum count. The maximum value the meter can show. It has the four full digit. And one half digit. Four full digit ranges from 0 to 9. And half digit will range from 0 to 1. So the maximum value it can show up to 1, 9, 9, 9, and 9. This is my maximum value it can be shown. I'll just put a box here, then it would be looks very good. Like in this digital meter. This is the maximum value that it can show. The first thing is clear that maximum value it can show is, this is my maximum count. This is my maximum count. This is my maximum count. Now, what is my full scale reading? It will be 200 volt. It will be 200 volts. So one count will be equal to 200 divided by 1, 9, 9, 9, 9. This is my one count. Okay. So now what it is saying, error specification has a 0.2% of reading in plus 10 counts. So first of all, I need to find what will be my 10 counts and the error will be my 10 counts. Multiplication with 200. Divided by 1, 9, 9, 9, 9, it will give you 0.1 volt. So till now everything is clear. You have calculated the value of one count from the maximum digit and the maximum reading, full scale reading, and then you have multiplied with the number of count whose reading is given to you. This is the simple thing you have done till now. Now, what you needed to do more that your instrument is reading at 100 volt. Your instrument is reading 100 volt, and for 100 volt it is showing 0.2% of error. So that will be my second error for you. And the final total error will be summation of this E1. This is become my E1, and E2 I will be solving in the next page. This has become my E1 and E2 I will be solving in the next page. Okay. So here in the second thing, the reading is 100. Reading is 100, and this reading 100 corresponds the error of 0.2%. So what will be the error in the value form? 0.2 divided by 100 multiplication with 100. It will be 0.2 volt. So the total error, this has become my E2, is my second error. The total error will be equal to, a total error will be equal to E1 plus E2. E1 is my 0.1 plus E2 is my 0.2, and it finally gives you 0.3 volt, and this will be the complete percentage of the percentage. What will you be getting? E1 plus E2 will be 0.3 volt, and this will be the complete percentage of what? This 100. So the complete percentage of the reading will become 0.3% of this 0.3 volt is of reading. So the complete error in percentage form will be 0.3%. Clear? I really hope this point is clear to all of you. Okay. I really hope this point is clear to all of you. This is a very nice question, was asked in the 2 marks for the GATE examination, but it is not that much of difficult question. I really hope now you are capable of getting the exact value. So that is why we are calculating the maximum error. The maximum error is in such a way, the error produced by both the cases, the error which is produced by both the cases, and this 0.3 volt is 0.3% of the 100 value, the reading value. This is my next question for you. I really hope you are enjoying the session. If you are enjoying the session, then please let me know, hit the like button and subscribe the channel if you are new to this. Okay, good. So this is my another question for you, question number 5. And an average reading of digital multimeter reads 10 volt when it is fed up to a triangular wave. Average value of the digital multimeter is 10 volt when it is fed up to a triangular wave. A symmetric about the time axis, for the same input, the RMS reading of the meter will be. So simply, this is a very easier question for triangular wave. I will share this PDF with you, so no worry if you are not writing it. For triangular wave, and my handwriting is also adjustable, so don't worry about, you can easily read this. For triangular wave, average value. Will be. Vm divided by 2, and that is also given. What is the 10 volt? From here, you can find the value of Vm, 20 volt. Now, you understood that the average value should be 10 volt, and this is the peak value you have calculated, that is the 20 volt. Now, for the same input, the RMS reading meter will be, for the RMS reading meter will be the RMS wave. RMS value of the same meter will be 1 divided by root 3. I have already given this thing previously. I have already given this thing previously, so this will become 20 divided by root over of 3. So A is my correct answer. I think I have already given how to calculate in my previous sections. I have already given how to calculate this thing. Okay. So this is why I am just not going through the complete value. And please, I suggest all of you who are watching the video first time or previously have also seen this, that you should watch these video, because with these only 9 to 10 videos, your complete subject is going to be covered. Your complete subject will be covered. Don't worry about it. And this is the reason I have applied it in both the different languages, so that the maximum number of students can also understand and can also feel benefited with this kind of knowledge what we are sharing here. Clear? So please go through all the videos, and these videos are, this is my genuine advice, because these videos will definitely going to give you much more confidence, and you will feel after these videos that this measurement subject is the easiest subject in the electrical engine. Okay. Although it is the easiest subject, then only, but if most of the students haven't done much things about it, haven't read it. So for those students, I am just advising you to go through all the important videos of this playlist. In playlist you will find it, and from there you can see. So this is my next question. This is again the same question. Again the same question. Fx divided by Fy you need to calculate. There is some misconception in the answers, but I am just giving you the correct one. Okay. So in this question, what the basic thing is, the outer, this is the outer branch. This is the outer rectangle which you are seeing here, the outer rectangle. You should not count this outer rectangle. Simply, you should not count this outer rectangle. And simply, there will be two branches, like one is this, one is this. Now, if you want to know the vertical, vertical tangents and the horizontal tangents, the vertical tangents are proportional to the horizontal frequency and the horizontal tangents are proportional to the vertical frequency. So first of all, I would calculating the vertical tangents. Vertical tangents are 2, 1 and 2. This is 1 and this is 2. So this will become 2. As the vertical tangents are proportional to the horizontal frequency. So this is my horizontal frequency. Divided by how many tangents are here? 1, 2 and 3. Very simply, you have calculated the value of this change in frequencies. Multiple times in the examination, these kind of question has been asked. Multiple times in the GATE examination, in the EAC examination, in the PSU examination, in most of the examination, this question has been asked. Even in the SSC JEE examination, such kind of question has been asked throughout. Okay, throughout from most and most of the times they are asking this kind of question, and this kind of question are very very easier if you know this approach. Okay. So next one is the more easier one. You cannot get easier question than this. Okay. So a single phase energy meter has a rating of 1200 resolution per kilowatt hour. If a 50 watt electric gadget is used for 4 hours, the energy meter will make how many number of revolutions? How many number of revolution it will make? So basically, if you wanted to calculate such kind of things very easily, you can do one thing. Write it here, 1200 revolution per kilowatt hour. So simply you just equate the units. Just equate the units, just calculate the unit, and then after you'll just going to get the final answer. So just you want to cancel out this kilowatt hour. So multiply with 500 watt, multiplied with 4 hours. Again, the kilowatt is not cancelled. So this will become 1200 revolution per kilowatt hour, multiplied with 0.5 kilowatt and 4 hour. Now hour and kilowatt got cancelled out, and this will become 1200 multiplied with 0.5 multiplied with 4. This will become 2400 revolution. This is my correct answer for you. This 2400 revolution is the correct answer for you in this case. And I really hope you are enjoying the session. If you are enjoying the session, then please let me know. Please let me know if you are enjoying the session. This is my next question for you. This is again a very, very, very easier question. Previously, we have done the extension of voltage range, and now this is the extension of current range. This is simply the extension of current range. So, simply, what the question is saying, the moving coil instrument has a resistance of 0.1 ohm. So, Rm, you know, first of all, the thing you know is Rm is what? 0.6. Now, second thing, the full scale deflection at 0.1 ampere. So, Im, current in the meter, will be 0.1 again. Convert to into the ammeter of 0 to 15 ampere. I will be 15 ampere. The resistance should be connected in shunt. This is what you needed to find out. This is my meter. So finally, what you know that RSH will be equal to RM times. So I have previously I have calculated all these things. Okay, I have derived all these things previously also. M minus 1. What will be M here? M will be I divided by IM. This will become 15 divided by 0.1. It will give you 150. This will be 0.6 divided by 150 minus 1. The answer for RSH will be 0.004. This is a shunt reactor, shunt resistor used, material used is manganese. Manganese material is used for this. Clear? Moving ahead for my next question, please tell me the correct answer for this one. Please tell me the correct answer for this one. Two resistors whose value is R1. R1 plus R2. You need to find out the value in this case. R will be equal to what? R will be equal to, the final R will be equal to 36 plus 75. This will become 111. This will become 111 ohms. Okay, this will become 111 ohms. Okay. After this, what you can do? After this, you have to put it in the formula of, in the formula of the plus, for the plus, we have a formula in measurement system that for dr by r will be equal to plus minus. This formula is valid only for the दिस फॉर्मुला इज वैलिड ओनली फॉर द परसेंटेज केस. इन द फॉर द परसेंटेज केस दिस फॉर्मुला इज वैलिडेटेड. सो नेक्स्ट थिंग डी आर बाय दिस थिंग एक्स वन डिवाइडेड बाय नॉट एक्स वन आर वन डिवाइडेड बाय आर डी आर वन बाय डी आर वन डी आर वन बाय आर वन प्लस आर टू बाय आर आर दिस इज द परसेंटेज. व्हाट परसेंटेज? 5%. दिस इज अगेन 5%. Again the percentage of this case. Now calculate the complete value here. Calculate the complete value. You know the value of 36 divided by 111 multiplication 5% plus 75 divided by 111 multiplication how much? 5%. So you need to calculate this. Please tell me the correct answer. Take out common. 5% will be common. 5% will be common. And please tell me the correct answer for this case. If you do the correct answer, in this case will become what? This dr by r will become again plus minus 5%. So this is my statement for this error connection. If in the addition case if the value of error percentage are same, then the error percentage value of the resultant, the error percentage value of the resultant term will also be same. So will also be same. It will also be 5%, and this is also 5%, though the resultant value would be having only 5%. So what will be the answer? 1 plus minus 5%. What will be the 5% of 111? 5.55% will be the answer. So there C is the correct answer. 111 plus minus 5.5 ohm. In this case, so this is my correct answer. So I am moving ahead further for this question. This is again, this is basically question in the gate examination asked in the signal and system. But here you can calculate the values. Okay. So suppose what they are asking, to find out the value of the root mean square value. Before doing it, firstly, you just needed to shift this waveform toward the right side. What will it become? It will become that shift this waveform toward the right side to 0.3 value. Seconds. Shift should be provided in this waveform. So what will it become? This point will become 0. This point will become 1. This point will become 3. And this point will become 4. And your complete time period will be this. And your complete waveform is repeating after this 4 seconds. And if your complete waveform is repeating after this 4 seconds, you can calculate the value of RMS value here. So the RMS value you can find out easily now. It will be 1 divided by 4 complete cycle. 1 divided by 4 in the bracket I am writing. In the bracket it is integration 0 to 1. Now integration 0 to 1, what is the value? 4. 4 square dt plus integration this 1 to 3 minus 2 square dt plus integration 3 to 4 0 dt bracket close, again a bracket close, and this is the bracket and this is 1 divided by 2. Please calculate this complete term and you will get the final value of the RMS value. You will get the final RMS value. Please calculate the complete term, you will get the final RMS value. I'll just give you the in the chat section, I'll give you the answer of this thing. The answer will be, please calculate it, this will be root over of 6. Please tell me what will be the correct answer. Now if the question was asked to please calculate the value of average value, if the average value was asked from 0 to 1, what is the magnitude? 4 plus from 1 to 3, it means for time period 2, what will be the magnitude? Minus 2. 4 minus 4, average value will be 0. Average value will be 0. And RMS value will be root over of 6. These are the things which you needed to know in such kind of questions. These are the things which you needed to know in such kind of question. So this will be the next question I have. Okay, this is a theoretical question. The dual trace oscilloscope is said to operate in an alternate mode. The control input of the multiplexer is used in the Y circuits, is fed with a signal wave of frequency equal to, the correct answer for this question will be D, half of the frequency of the time-based sweep generator. Half of the frequency of the time-based sweep generator is the correct answer in this case. Okay. So again, this is my homework for you. This is my homework. I'll just, in the chat section, I'll give you the correct answer. The correct answer is here. But this question is the 1 mark gate question. So I really hope you have enjoyed the session. And if you have enjoyed the session, then please let me know in the by hitting the like button. And please tell me, are you enjoying the session? And just before all these things, I would just like to tell you something about this Unacademy Plus session. You can join Unacademy session by clicking on this link. You have to select your goal. What should be your goal? Gate and ESC. You have to click on the get subscription. Click. You have to select that for how many number of months you needed the subscription. I believe 1 year plan is one of the finest plan we have. You can use my code HEMLIFE to get 10% discount. Next, you can use debit card, credit card, any other card you have. And this is again, here the discount is applied and you get the discount. You can be part of the biggest group on Facebook for electrical and electronics and in instrumentation. It have around 150k members. Okay, so this is the biggest group for electrical we have. And the tiny URL, this is the Telegram link which you can find the PDF of this lecture also. Okay, so this is our slogan, Swagat Karoge Hamara. Thank you so much for being part of this video. I really hope you enjoyed these things and what knowledge we are sharing. And in the next video, we'll just wrap up all the things. And I really hope that you are enjoying at 5 p.m. Be there in my special session. I'll just post the link of my special session in the chat section. Clear? Okay. Thank you so much, guys.